I'm Sonny Webster. You used to come in my mama's bakery.
Sonny Webster?
Yeah.
Sonny Webster, I remember you.
You used to stand behind the cash register and give everybody the wrong change.
Well, I never was too good at math.
You're telling me?
Sonny Webster, golly.
Something tells me those characters are from the South. That's a scene from Norma Rae with Sally Field and Beau Bridges. It's about her attempt to unionize some downtrodden textile workers in the South. It's one of five new films we'll be reviewing on Sneak Previews, your guide to what's good and bad at your local movie theater. And this is Roger Ebert, the Pulitzer Prize-winning film critic of the Chicago Sun-Times.
Across the aisle from me is Gene Siskel, film critic of the Chicago Tribune and CBS TV News in Chicago. And sometimes, even most of the time, I suppose, when you walk out of the theater, you know whether a movie is good or bad or in between. But sometimes a movie really is hard to categorize, and Norma Rae is a movie like that. It never quite pulls itself together, and yet it has some really fine things in it. And one of the best things is the performance by Sally Field as Norma Rae Webster. She's 31, she's got a couple of kids, and she works in the textile mill like everybody else in this small southern town. And when a labor organizer turns up and tries to organize a union in the mill, his arguments make a lot of sense to her, so much sense that she becomes a full-time volunteer organizer, and that causes a lot of troubles at home.
You ain't getting any sleep. I ain't getting any sleep, and we gotta get to work in the morning.
I got 100 calls to make tonight.
Is that going on our phone bill?
You can take it out of my paycheck, right?
Damn, milk is sour.
I didn't have a chance to get to the market.
Well, you didn't have a chance to get to the market, did you? And you didn't get to the washing, and you didn't get to the kids, and you didn't get to me.
Is that right?
That's right. That's right. Damn TV dinners, kids going around in dirty jeans. I'm going around without, altogether.
You get behind me and lift up my nightie, and we're gonna make love.
Norma. Norma! Hey.
Maybe she feels a little guilty, and that's why they make up. You know, in a way, he has a point. She has been spending morning, noon, and night working for the union. But Sally Field really makes us believe in Norma Rae in scenes like that. And in the fierce and spunky way, she sticks to her guns. And along the way, Norma Rae finds herself developing into a different person, which is kind of what the movie is about. A new world has opened up to her, new ideas. And most of them come from Ron Liebman, who plays the union organizer from New York. One afternoon, they go for a swim.
What the hell is that? Get out. Something's slipping around my...
Those are minnows.
Those are what?
Minnows. They won't hurt you.
You better not.
You sure are a fish out of water down here.
This is not exactly my native habitat.
Reuben, what would you be doing on a day like this at home?
Play some handball at the Y. Go see Aida at the Met. Eat Chinese. Play a little poker, hit the sack.
I've been two places in my life. I've been to Henleyville. Been on down to Piston.
Oh, you'd love New York. You would. Wow. Super town. Most beautiful women in the world. Best food. Opera. Theater. Ballet.
Reuben.
Hey, Mama.
You're homesick.
Oh, yeah.
cut.
That scene is a little bit misleading because most of the picture takes place in the mill and not down at the old swimming hole, but that camaraderie between the two of them is at the heart of the film. But the rest of the movie has a lot of problems. The relationship between Norma Rae and her husband, Bo Bridges, for example, is never convincingly developed. It's stuck in. It never seems to fit. The screenplay is too predictable. Some of the dialogue of the mill worker sounds too self-conscious and too awkwardly ideological, and so the movie is flawed. It's not perfect. But it does succeed because of the sheer human intensity of that performance by Sally Field.
Yeah, she's very good. But as you mentioned, once we get to the mill, which is the main crux of the story, I suppose, you know, the film is such an obviously good heart. It's on the side of these oppressed workers. I don't know, films like that, they don't really impress me because they take such an easy road. I thought this should be a rougher film. I thought, for example, that using an organizer in the swimming hole there should have got his head knocked off as soon as he showed up in town.
Well, he doesn't, though, as a matter of fact. But the thing is, this movie kind of exists. People laugh at movie critics, I think. You're always talking about it works on this level, doesn't work on this level. This movie really doesn't work on the level of the story. It really does work on the level of that character that Sally Field creates. I'm thinking about a movie last year, An Unmarried Woman with Jill Clayburgh. Well, the year before that, she made Gable and Lombard. It was a flop. We all said, what a terrible actress. Then she came back. She was terrific. It's the same with Sally Field. She's been in a lot of mediocre roles. She's never really had a great performance until this film, and she creates a character we care about a lot more than we care about the movie.
Yes, I liked her, but there's one character that I hate in the picture, and that's the guy in that swimming hall. I'm getting back to him. Ron Liebman, he plays Kaz on TV, and he played this role of the brash young union organizer just like he was playing TV. He really chews up the cinema, you know, grimacing all the time. It was obnoxious. I wanted to punch this guy out.
The scene before that, we saw Bo Bridges. He's okay. He gives a good performance, but he gets married. That's one scene. They fight. That's another scene. There were just four or five scenes in the movie that are thrown in with her marriage that never seem to work with the relationship she has with Liebman.
Yeah, I guess you're saying there really are two movies. One, go see it if you like her, but the rest of the story doesn't make it at all.
Okay. And we had a closer split, though, on Norma Rae. Gene couldn't quite buy it. I could. He thought it was contrived. But we both thought, actually, it had a good heart and an excellent performance by Sally Field.